again, the University of St. LaSalle College of Arts and Sciences, Mathematics Department. Next up in our series of videos, which we call Algebra 101, if you're following, we have done a lot of things already in functions. So in this video, we're going to talk about another selected topics under functions, that is operations of functions. Okay, so if you can remember in your arithmetic, we do some operations there, right? So we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, but we do that in numbers, specifically in positive integers. Here, in our operations of functions video, we're going to operate functions this time. So we're not going to add, subtract, multiply, and divide numbers, but we're going to do those things in functions this time. Okay, so these are just defined by the four fundamental operations of algebra. For example, if we have an f and a g, again, remember f and g as only the names of the functions. So then we have four fundamental operations in algebra, which we will use in functions. Namely, first is we have the sum operation. So again, f plus g, these are the names of the functions. These are not variables again. So f plus g of x is equal to the individual f of x plus g of x. So as you can see, we're just adding them to get the sum, you know. Next is difference. So the difference, you know that. The difference is by getting the number subtracted by another one. Okay, so we have f minus g of x equals f of x minus g of x. So, compared to the sum, this is commutative. So if whatever we do with a f and g, it's still going to be the same sum. But in difference, we will really have a big difference if the ordering of the functions differs. Okay, so in sum, f plus g and g plus f are just the same. In difference, it's different when you say f minus g and g minus f. So please take note of that. We also have product. So again, this is commutative. So f times g of x is just equal to f of x times g of x, or g of x times f of x, since multiplication is commutative. Just take note, in some other books, they don't use the raised dot anymore. So we call this the raised dot, if you can remember. We started using this in algebra when x came in. So some books don't use an operation, like a visible operation in between. They just, you know, put f and g together. That signifies multiplication already. As you know, numbers which are beside each other are being multiplied. So just take note of that. In some books, they don't put a raised dot in between. So simply, we're just multiplying. And lastly, but not the least, it's the quotient. So we have f over g of x is just equal to the individual functions f of x divided by g of x. And this should be noted that g of x should not be equal to 0. Again, we don't want to have any denominator of 0. It's really not healthy to have that. Okay, so we're going to first cite some examples in sum. That is in this part here. So, for example, first, given we have an f of x equals 3x, g of x equals x plus 1, and we have h of x equals x squared minus 2. So, for number 1 and number 2, we are asked to find f plus g of x and then g plus h of x. Okay, so how can we get the solution here? So, first up, in number 1, f plus g of x is equal to, again, f of x plus g of x. So first step that we're going to do is to copy the f of x, which is 3x, here. Copy the sign, plus. G of x is x plus 1, copy it here. So thus, we have this statement here. So it's very ideal to put parentheses first every time we substitute. We did that in the evaluation because it's much easier to see. If we're going to do some operations between, we could combine terms. So for example, we have a plus here outside, so we need to distribute the plus. It's a very different thing if this is a minus here, and we'll get to that. So we have 3x plus x plus 1. So again, looking at the like terms, you know, like terms as terms that we can combine, provided they have the, number one, they have the same variable. Number two, they have the same degree or exponent. So 3x, x is raised to 1, doesn't have any visible exponent here, but there's a 1 there. X also here has a 1 here, so 3x plus x, that they're like terms, so we can combine them. So 3x plus x is equal to, okay, that's 4x, and then a constant 1 is visible in this part, so we can just write it down. So this is our answer then. F plus g of x is equal to 4x plus 1. So how can we say that we have arrived at the answer? So we have arrived at an answer if there's no more simplification that can be done. So we cannot simplify 4x plus 1 anymore. So that's the final answer for this operation plus, okay, so or sum function, f plus g of x. Next up for number 2, so we have g plus h of x. Again, g of x is x plus 1, copy it here in this first part. H of x is x squared minus 2, copy it here in the second part, since g plus h is in this order. So we have g plus h of x is equal to x plus 1, it's here, plus x squared minus 2. X squared minus 2. So again, we're going to look at the like terms. X, okay, next question. Is x, or can x be combined with x squared? Okay, so answering that question is like asking, are they like terms? Okay, so certainly they have the same variable, that is x, but do they have the same degree? Yes, certainly not. So x has a degree of 1, x has a degree of 2. As you can see, it's x squared. So we cannot combine both of this. So let me just write them down as simple, so x plus x squared. Okay, and certainly we can combine these two constant terms here. So we have plus 1 and then we have minus 2. So 1 minus 2 is minus 1. So thus we have this answer. G plus h of x is equal to x plus x squared minus 1. Okay, so as you can see here in our middle answer, the degree is not in order. So it's really good in practice to put the variables and their degrees in order, so from greatest to least. So we write here first the x squared plus x minus 1. Copy the minus 1. And that will be our answer for this number 2. Hopefully it's clear here in the sum function. Let's proceed to the difference one. Okay, so for the difference function, we have here our formula, f minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. So again, like I said, the order is very important here in the difference. Let's see why. So given the same functions, f of x equals 3x, g of x equals x plus 1, h of x equals x squared minus 2, find number 1, f minus g of x, and number 2, g minus h of x. So for our solution for number 1, so again, we're going to copy the f of x answer here, the f of x value, 3x here, okay, minus g of x. So g of x is x plus 1. So we have f of x minus g of x. Okay. Okay, so you can see it here. Again, in practice, it's very good to put them first in parentheses. Okay, now what happened in this next line? Okay, so again, like I said, it's very good to put them in parentheses first so that we could know if we will do some exponentiation first or some multiplying first before we could simplify things. Okay, now, we can see here that our operation in between is minus or subtraction. So what we need to do is we need to, before we could even simplify or combine terms, we need to distribute this minus 1, this, imagine there's a 1 here, minus 1 or negative 1 to both numbers in here. Okay, so if we're going to do that, minus 1 times x is certainly going to give us negative x, negative 1 times positive 1 is going to give us negative 1. So this will be the statement after we distributed the minus sign here. So as you can see, it's a clean one. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to combine like terms. We will combine 3x minus x. They're like terms because they have the same variable, number 1. Number 2, they have the same degree, so with a degree of 1. So 3x minus x is like saying, imagine there's an imaginary 1 in this middle term here. So 3x minus 1x is going to give us 2x. Copy this minus 1, so we have this answer here. Okay, and this will be our answer for number 1 solution. Okay, this should be minus. Let me edit that in a while. Okay, so f minus g of x is equal to 2x minus 1. So, done. Okay, simple as it is. Now, let's proceed to number 2. So, g minus h of x. So, you could imagine here what will be our statement on the right-hand side. G of x minus h of x. So, what we will do is to copy the value of g of x, that is x plus 1 over here. minus h of x, which is x squared minus 2. So again, we need to get rid of this minus sign in between. So what we will do is to distribute this minus sign to the x squared and to the minus 2. So if we're going to do that, so negative 1, imagine there's a 1 here, negative 1 times x squared is negative x squared. Negative 1 times negative 2 is going to give us positive 2. So thus we have this line. Okay, again, it's very clear that we cannot combine x and negative x squared since they're not like terms, they don't have the same degree. But we could certainly combine 1 and 2. That will become, well, 3. So we will have this notion here. So x minus x squared. We have a minus x squared since x squared is being has been multiplied by negative 1. So we have negative x squared here. So x minus x squared plus 1 plus 2. That will give us certainly 3 here. And by practice, it's much better to put the one with the highest degree in front. So we have negative x squared plus x plus 3. And that is our answer. Okay.